And Joe.
Yes, sir.
Domestic terrorism within the country, and access was limited to a certain group headed by Rod Rosenstein. This became known as the Dirty Trick Squad in Baltimore. This is where they were using Hammer, Sunrise, Sunset, things like that, to illegally spy on people, corrupt, attempted to corrupt judges, compromise them, Hillary Clinton, others. I mean, it was just ongoing. They concentrated on judges, but they wanted to concentrate on this. And they would illegally compromise people, illegally wiretap, break into computers, plant, reverse, change information, change emails, things of that nature. And it was in this capacity of working with them that information about the judges and Roberts and Pence and things like that had come out. I've tried several times in the past to get it out and was thoroughly squashed by Rod and the DOJ and the FBI to a horrible extent. I tried to get in 2015. Tried to end run them and go to the Department of Homeland Security. But on the video, I tried to warn President Trump about the people he was dealing with daily, and especially Rob and Pence, things like that, as they were working together to remove them, trying to compromise the people around them, get their landing when they possibly could.
And how were Rod and Rod Rosenstein and Mike Pence connected?
That group, I mean, they're all interconnected in one way or another. That particular group was Rod, VP Pence, Paul Ryan. That was the core of that group. Robert was in there, but that was the core of it, and it was an attempt where Rod was the brilliant legal mind behind it to remove President Trump under the 25th Amendment. But that's an old movie because that's somebody being passed over for promotion, which they both felt they were. You know, VP Pence hated President Trump because he had taken his slot as rightful president. He felt that he did. And Paul Ryan was actually considered running as well for a vice presidential slot, and Mitt Romney was also involved. But they don't believe that President Trump's an outsider who had not paid his dues. They just didn't like him. So once VP Pence was in there, once President Trump was elected, obviously Vice President Pence, I just walked away and everything became very quiet. I was their mole inside, someone who could run interference, leak certain things, and just keep tabs on the president, manage him.
So was this a friendly relationship between Mike Pence and Rosenstein, or was there any kind of leverage being placed on the president or the vice president at the time?
There was leverage on Mike Pence. Because of surveillance from way back in the 2013 range, that they had gotten FISA warrants to exploit, and Rod had that. He wanted a vice presidential slot himself. You know, if they could remove President Trump, Vice President Pence becomes president, and Rod felt that he would be the natural selection for it. Paul Ryan felt differently, as did Mitt Romney, but that was the overall goal, each one fighting for. The vice presidential slot. Rod thought he was a clear winner because of his legal brilliance and his management of the Mueller investigation and special counsels and things. You know, he would be the one to remove the president, damage him so thoroughly he could be removed, and he deserved it.
Do you know what type of leverage would have existed over the vice president?
The vice president has had homosexual relations in the past. Many of them were adults. This is something he had done throughout his time in Congress. When he became governor, he thought that he was free to explore them more. There were two specifically that they had recorded. One gentleman, roughly 20 years his junior, they had a fairly steady relationship. There was one about half his age. It was much more sporadic. It's considered because it was more dangerous, harder to get time alone. And it was that second one that introduced younger and younger people. This is whomever, he's 17, he's only 15. Remember, he's 15, he's really 13. And Rod and Roberts, the Chief Justice Roberts, a lot of the younger people involved, the ones that were brought as favors, were supplied by Jeffrey Epstein's channels, through his channels, his people. They were able to get FISA warrants because, of course, Chief Justice Roberts had a FISA court and helped them prepare them, but it was also Epstein was intelligence asset of some type to various agencies around the world. They used his information, they exploited it for their own good. So when he was here, or his people were here, it was easy enough to justify a FISA warrant on them. The FBI would enact the warrant, surveil everything, document it, but they would not help anyone, they would not save a child, they would not reveal it was more important than having the leverage on everything. And of course, this is under their own corrupt ideas, but under Rod, his tutelage. And they wanted the leverage.
All right. So I'm going to ask you if we could get into some more of the details with the Dirty Trick Squad and how Rosenstein was a part of that group, and if Roberts had any type of
intentions, Secret Service, Rosati, Joseph Rosati, who was a DEA, Alan Borishok, who was ATF, Greg Utz, who was the TFO with the DEA, but he was formerly Baltimore County Police. This was the basis of the Dirty Trick Squad, the computer experts. You had the muscle, you had the technical experts, and that's what they were doing. And then there was another group in Fort Washington who was running one down there. This was a satellite location in Baltimore just for the really illegal stuff, illegal communications, hacking, phone tapping, you name it. And those people, well, they concentrated their main focus all the time, Title III judges, federal judges. But they were going to train on political rivals, sitting politicians, anybody they needed to go after, anybody they pointed at. They went after family members of judges and compromised people as much as they possibly could. They had no problem hacking computers and planting information to compromise people. This is something they had done numerous times. Gerard had done this for years and years, so at Sheldon Bridges, where they would finagle a case that they had before the court, where, for instance, they would arrest the gentleman, and he had money, he had property, and so on. He had the resources to fight them. They didn't like that. So Sheldon would go in, plant child porn on a computer, and let you know, an examination, now you got this on there. I don't know anything about it. Well, it's on there, we're going to charge him. And then he didn't want that. It ruined his life, didn't want to go to prison as a pedophile. You know what happens. And things like that. And they would use this as leverage in hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of cases. And then he would plead, as the person they charged would plead to a lesser charge that would not show up on the record, but he would have to forfeit property, money, things like that. And they would skim their percentage off. Sheldon Bridges was particularly good at it. It was his specialty. Maybe he had done this at the county and state levels, why he had got in trouble a couple times, which is why he came under the slate of Rod Rosenstein and got him up to federal. Sheldon did not like Obama. Didn't like Hillary. He had access to the White House, the Air Force One, CIA, NSA. He had those kind of clearances. He's the number one expert on forensic study of the computers for the Secret Service and for most of the government.
Now, was he a government employee? Was he a contractor?
He was Secret Service. He was a Secret Service agent.
Okay.
Secret Service agent. So he had access to all these things, but because of his clearances, because of his expertise, he could go anywhere. He was often in the White House texting the location of the President, Obama, what they were doing. He hacked Obama's BlackBerry just for fun. Things like that. He shared messages with people. Hacked the girls' phones. It was nothing for him. He had lists of people that he would just call up and watch them do their daily stuff. He's just truly gifted with the computers. I'm good at the computers. I can do anything you need, but he's just one of those people born to do it.